Thank you, Madam Chair, and thank you for this hearing. You know, I represent the second, third, and fourth largest city in Illinois, Joliet, Aurora, and Naperville. And they're rolling through here on the screens are these redlining pictures. And I remember trembling with rage when I saw the redlining pictures of Joliet and Aurora from the 1930s. And then driving through those neighborhoods and see how their futures had been determined by this, you know, bigoted, racist set of policies. I also represent Naperville, which until well into the 20th century was what was called a sundown town. So they didn't have any redlining issues there. But it's gotten better. It's really gotten better in Joliet, in Naperville, in Aurora. And a part of that, a big part of that, were the federal policies that leaned heavily against this. And, you know, I was reading through the Facebook, the complaint against Facebook, which sort of brought that same level of rage. I don't think this was intentional, but it just underlines the danger in the power that's been given these companies. That although Facebook themselves probably didn't deliberately do this, I am convinced there are many landlords out there that would take advantage of this, the ability to do that. And it underlines, you know, the fact that Congress hasn't been paying enough attention to the power of tech on this. But then on the other side, it's what could you do to actually fix this and use the power of tech for a positive way? Ms. Goldberg or Ms. Hill, I can't remember, was talking about doing electronic testing, you know, essentially simulating landlords. You could potentially, you know, have access to, you know, when someone puts out an ad, say, okay, that's fine, you've set this criteria, but those criteria will discriminate against X, Y, and Z, and let the person, you know, thinking about putting that ad out there, get immediate feedback from Facebook that this is a discriminatory set of criteria that you have. And is Facebook, to your knowledge, talking about that sort of immediate feedback so that even, say, an individual landlord will not inadvertently do this?
So I can speak to that. What Facebook has done is committed to taking off of its platform, creating a new portal for people who want to advertise services related to housing, employment, and credit, so that they will create ads through a different mechanism than other people who are creating ads for other kinds of goods and services. And that housing, employment and credit portal will not offer the options of any categories that you can either include or exclude that reflect.
But the number of proxies assets that you can generate
for these is... It's a lot, but, and we will be working with them and monitoring what they do over the next 3 years to ensure that all of the categories that might have a discriminatory effect are removed. I would say, I think, two things if I could in response to your question further. One is that in the context of Facebook, the problem is not just in the ad creation to begin with. That was clear, and that's what some of the main provisions of our settlement agreement speak to. But a problem that neither we nor Facebook actually knows how to figure out, but we'll be looking at over the next 3 years, is the way that its algorithm delivers ads to people, even when those ads don't have any discriminatory targeting, based on the other information that Facebook has about people and who it thinks will be most likely to respond to an ad, sure, right? And the other ad campaigns that may be running, which reflect the historic discrimination in our society. So it's a real problem. And we're hopeful that by working together, we'll be able to get to the bottom of it. I would just say, if I could, that I think the Facebook problem is a big one, and I hope that we're on a good path to tackling that. But it's not the only one. And the way we see algorithms and big data work, for example, in the mortgage lending space, is a little bit different. And so it's going to take a little bit different kind of tools to address that.
Yeah. Now, and then on the other side, you can imagine a situation. We spend a whole lot of money trying to subsidize socioeconomic integration in our communities. I mean, it's a really good thing. It's a better outcome for the whole community. And so have people ever thought of it? We have all this big data so that, for example, just paying, say, Facebook, if their ad results in a placement of a family in a neighborhood which increases socioeconomic integration, that somehow, you know, they get rewarded for that monetarily. Is that sort of idea ever been talked about to just use these big data sets for good? If you could answer that for the record, I'd appreciate it. Yield back.
The gentleman from Tennessee, Mr. Kustoff, is recognized for 5 minutes.